In this video, I share 8 quick masking fluid tips, from the very basics to actually fixing those mistakes. Let's get started. And this is my blue mask, one by SAA, but there's a variety of them on the market. Now, masking fluid does have a bit of a shelf life, and you'll find that with all masking fluids. You can always tell, but it starts to smell a bit off, because we know they're always latexy, aren't they? So you tend to find, after a while, you get used to the smell. And when you smell it again after a few months, you think, that smells a little bit iffy. Not quite the right smell. And eventually, they can stain the paper. I'm not sure about this one, whether it will or not. So it may not. And if it does, what I tend to do is just go over the top of that with some details. Just kind of hide it away. We can hide things. We can move things around on our painting. I'm just using the back of a brush, by the way, to mix it. So give it a gentle mix. Don't shake it vigorously, otherwise it'll go all bubbly inside there. Wipe all that off. Okay, some old kitchen roll I've got here. But when it's a coloured masking fluid, you can also see when it's not mixed properly. See all the blue under there? Though? So I need to make sure that all this blue has gone. Now, testing the masking fluid to see if it's dry, what you tend to find, it's still shiny, so it's still really shiny on the paper, as you can see, but you can just see a change of colour as well. And also, it goes very tacky as well, and it doesn't come off on your finger. So you know when it's dry enough to kind of work with. So tacky, believe it or not, is dry. I know, very odd, isn't it? Very odd stuff. So, there we go. Okay, now I need to leave this to dry for maybe 2-3 hours, something like that, until it's really bone dry, and then I can take the masking fluid off. Please don't try drying this with a hairdryer or anything like that, because if you do, because the paper's wet underneath, it could be wet underneath the masking fluid all the way inside here as well. So what will happen if you dry this with a hairdryer, it will harden that masking fluid, and then when you try to peel the masking fluid off, there's a chance it could tear the paper, so be very careful. Now, masking fluid. Dry your finger, first of all. Like that. Okay, preferably not the one that's bruised. So dry your finger, and then very lightly roll in towards the subject. And the reason why I do that is simply because if it does tear the paper, we want it to tear inside rather than into that lovely background we've just done. Because any tears on the inside of the pine marten, we can very easily cover up with some detail, can't we? All right. Difficult to do that when you've got the whiskers there as well, but we'll do what we can. So roll it all the way in towards the middle. Now, I know some people grab the end and pull it off as well. I wouldn't recommend that because you really want to take your time with this and make sure you get it all off. And also have full control over where it's going to go. Because if you pull it, it can very often just splinter everywhere. Look at that. Lovely, lovely. And you can see the effect that certainly had there. Look. See, that's just pulled a little bit of paper off just here. See that? And just very lightly tease that off. So you've got to be careful when that happens. This is what I mean, that it can sometimes tear the paper. I can very easily cover that up on the inside, so that's not a problem at all. Now there were two areas where the masking fluid, I see three areas saying that, has just taken off just a small amount of paper. So all I've done, a very light, I've got one little area left there, look, just show you. So I'll just zoom in a minute, so you can just see a bit closer up. So when you compare that one there, see that? That should be more or less parallel one another, those two lines, but I've got this little area which sticks out. So I need to repair that. So all I'm gonna do is get some of the green, which is from yesterday, which is this one here, look. Nice and dry, just use a damp brush, that's all you're doing. Don't wet it through. Just a very damp brush, lightly dampened brush. Just lightly wet the area there. Then just very carefully, just tap probably this area here. We can always kind of work out the overall edge of this as I go along. So I'm just tapping with the very tip of the brush. That's all I'm doing, that. I'm going to wash that brush out. take most of the water off and very lightly just tap the edge of that. Don't rub it because you'll start to remove the paint on the paper itself. I did say about masking fluid and that it can sometimes remove the paper. Even though I was careful when I took this off and I kind of rolled the masking fluid in the line of the claw itself and the leg, or the toe in this case, should I say, it still, even then, still took some paint off there, there, and there. But by doing this, you can sort of repair it and it looks okay. I'm happy enough with that. And the same with this one. You can just see the slight tear mark there, look. Just roll that there. See that? The edge of the paper that's torn. And there. But to be honest with you, these are things that are not going to be that noticeable once you've painted all the main image. This is just going to sort of disappear down there anyway. And once it's dry, if you wanted to, just come in. Where's my bit of tissue paper? And just very lightly go over that very edge. That edge there, look. Then lift. Just to soften this one little edge there. Then that will get rid of that little line of paper there, look. And that's just about disappeared. What I want to do is try and take some of these hard edges off the edge of the wings here. Because they are a little bit hard, and when we start doing the delicate colours in between, these will stand out far too much. It will act like an outline, which obviously we want to try and avoid. So what we're going to do is get, this is a size 1 brush which I'm using at the moment. I'm just going to get a piece of paper and just put my hand on it. I'll just zoom in a little bit for you. You say, ball I can't see. Okay. Right. So, wet the brush, but don't have it dripping wet. We don't want it running off like a waterfall. So, when you look at some of these marks along the edge here, I wonder if we can go a bit closer for you. Just bear with me a minute. So, probably around there. Hopefully that's close enough. So when you look at some of these marks, I'm going to just dampen it with the tip of the brush. That's all I'm doing, as you can see. Just the very tip. And then, whilst it's wet, very quickly, dab it off. And you can see that soften that edge down. Just that little bit, just enough. I'll just show you again on this bit. So just by softening it down. So with a damp brush, it's not dripping wet. Keep working it, and then very quickly, come in with the tissue. If it's not quite enough, you can go again. But eventually, you could just stick to the paper and you won't be able to get it off. So, just keep trying. That's better. Right. One thing I do know I've missed, and no, I don't believe I've done this, there's a little gap here, look. That should just be one thin blade of grass there, and this should be the background. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to wet that area there and drop some of our colours back in there. Just it matches the rest of it, really, okay? Don't believe I've done that. So what I'm trying to do is match the colours just above here. So you know we've got the purpley blue there, look, which is this colour here. I'm trying to match that with the one below, so it sort of follows through. So if you make a mistake like this, so we all make mistakes, don't we? Then you know that you can fix that, because it's just a matter of filling in that little gap, but with the right colours as well. So it's anything that's around the same area. I lifted off a small section here, where we've got a green leaf there, I know. Okay. Just so that I remember that's there, and that will do. If you'd like to learn more about applying masking fluid and the tools that I use, check out the video to the top right. I'll see you there.